Welcome back. Let's take a look at the Forex markets. So we've been joined on the show by a Forex trader with Access Bank, Ifueko Olotu. Ifueko, welcome to the program.
Thank you.
Now, what is the Naira trading at the moment at the interbank market?
Currently, the Naira is trading at about 317, 318 levels. We opened the market at about 317, and most of the trades were done at 318.
Now, we saw the Naira close at around 400 to the greenback, that is on the parallel market, last week on Friday, and the market, we've seen that the market will be closing very shortly. Now, should we expect a wide margin in the numbers today, that is between the parallel market now and the interbank FX markets?
Yes, you should. You should still see that wide margin because we just before I came on air, CBN just came in to sell. So the likelihood is that rates could come lower.
What level of demand are we getting at the markets?
Sorry?
What kind of demand are you getting as traders?
Well, the demand is still there. And that's why we're seeing that that spike in the parallel market. The demand is there. The liquidity is still low. So all of the drama you are seeing at the interbank market and at the parallel market is a fallout of the illiquidity. So we still see that heavy demand, particularly for invisible trades.
So what is your outlook for the market? What should we expect from traders, from the markets in general this week?
Given where the parallel market has gone to, we're going to probably see more aggressive demand at higher rates. So we're likely to see a depreciation in the rates in the very near future if the liquidity situation remains this way.
Okay, so we expect more liquidity in the market then?
No, we're expecting a further depreciation in rates
okay.
If the liquidity situation remains this way.
Thank you so much, Ifueko Olotu, Forex trader with Access Bank. Italian oil firm Eni has wrapped up long-running talks to sell a multi-billion-dollar stake in its planned Mozambique liquefied natural gas development to ExxonMobil. The offshore gas reserves already discovered by Eni in Area 4 are large enough to need a giant land-based LNG export plant whose proximity to Asian and Middle Eastern growth makes it potentially a highly lucrative project. Now, talks to bring in technically savvy partner with deep pockets like ExxonMobil have dragged on due to differences over valuations in the light of falling oil and gas prices. In 2013, Eni sold 20% of its Area 4 license to China's CNPC for $4.2 billion. But since then, oil and gas prices have come down by more than half. However, last year, Mozambique awarded Exxon 3 offshore exploration license blocks of its own, which sit to the south of Eni's discoveries, giving a new dimension to development prospects. In Zambia, Glencore's a copper mine unit has lifted its suspension of production at an underground mine that followed the death of 3 miners in an accident. Reports from the Mine Workers Union of Zambia says that the suspension of output across all Mopani copper mines was lifted at midnight after all employees involved in the production were briefed on the importance of following safety rules. Okay, with that report, with that story, we've come to the end of Business Incorporated. Many thanks for watching. We do appreciate your time with us on the program. I am Bolaji Akinwale. Bye for now.